What's up, internet? My name's Ori. Welcome back to the channel. It is Wednesday, September 4th, day number 51 inside the Big Brother house. Plans to form a new alliance got squashed last night. MJ is playing with Cam's hair, and Chelsie is playing everyone. Let's talk about that, plus all the intel drama and more from yesterday's live feeds. But first, if you are new here, hit that subscribe button. You like this video, hit that like button, hit that notification bell. You'll never miss a video. You'll never miss a stream. To give you guys a little bit of a recap, if you haven't been keeping along with everything going on the feeds, Quinn won HOH, Angela, Chemo, and Rubina were his original nominees, his target being Angela. Leah, though, then won veto and used it on Angela despite Quinn's desperate pleas for her not to. He then put up Joseph as his replacement nominee. Now, yesterday was fairly chill, but lots of movement on the whole vote front, where the votes are going to land, what's going to take place. Let's kind of go over everything that happened. First off, we had T-Core and Chelsie meeting up, talking more about the Girls Alliance and how they could possibly get the votes to keep Chemo if it's him versus Joseph. Later, we actually heard T-Core telling Rubina that they should do another ladies' night to kind of lock in that Girls Alliance. Chelsie also told Chemo and Rubina that, hey, I will be voting for Joseph to leave no matter what. But she can't say what she would do if it's either of the two of them should Joseph end up winning the AI arena. Now, the Girls Alliance thing could actually have some legs behind it since Chelsie is involved. She talked to MJ about possibly having the numbers to have this be a thing should Rubina stay. It would be 6-3, I believe, right? If Joseph ended up leaving, it would be 6-3. They would have a lot of numbers for the girls thing. But they also then debated whether or not Rubina and Chemo should be the ones to go, because either way, it brings T-Core closer to them, and that Rubina is kind of the glue that holds them together. Without her, Chemo and T-Core wouldn't know what to do with themselves and would be completely lost without her. So that's kind of a thing that's going on. And then later, Chelsie, when she was alone, says that she actually thinks Rubina will end up going because Chemo's could potentially win the AI arena. So that's saying that Rubina would go over Joseph in that scenario. And I also think in that case, Chemo would go over Joseph as well due to some of the discussions that's been going on. Really interesting that Chelsie once again is playing T-Core, but not only T-Core, but Chemo and Rubina as well. While covering her bases with the whole Girls Alliance idea, she later ended up telling T-Core that, you know, they should hold off on actually locking it in before, you know, HOH kind of let that happen and just kind of plant seeds beforehand, which she had done earlier with Angela as well. So Chelsie's really doing a good job of kind of positioning herself in a really good spot with both the Girls Alliance thing and potentially getting out Rubina this week or even Chemo, depending which way the votes end up landing. But I think it actually seems like Chemo could be in a lot of danger here. There's also the situation, though, with MJ and Cam and the whole petting stuff that's happening, which it's still going on, but not only is it being noticed by Chelsie and T-Core now, it's even being brought up by other people, including Joseph, to Quinn. Speaking of, Joseph asked Quinn, like, hey, does Chemo know he's the target? Which Quinn kind of said, yeah, I think he does, right? And that either way, they should have the votes to keep Joseph. Joseph also told Quinn, like, hey, this is some Memphis and Dan level stuff here, right? Like, with nominating your ally, like, we're really cool, huh? It's like, oh, no, not really. Leah just kind of forced his hand. Like, that's what this really is all about. Speaking of Quinn, he wanted to lock in an alliance with MJ, Leah, Chelsie, Cam, and himself last night. And they planned on meeting up in the HOH later in the evening. But as they did so, T-Core and Rubina were kind of posted up outside in that lounge area by the fish, kind of watching them all go in one by one. And everybody was in there except for MJ. And T-Core and Rubina were kind of like, this is kind of interesting, right? Like, where was our invite? Chemo ended up joining them. And they're like, if MJ shows up and goes in there, I'm really going to be suspicious of what's going on. And as they say, like, let's just go in there. Let's just break it up and go on in. MJ shows up. So they all end up going on in there. Eventually, even Joseph ended up showing up. MJ started petting Cam again, and Chelsie kind of dipped with that. And it all really fell apart very quickly. Quinn was very upset, I think, by not having the ability to form this alliance started getting a little emotional. He played it off like he was emotional that somebody would be leaving, especially that someone not being Angela this week. But I think more so he was just upset that he couldn't lock in this alliance that he was trying to do all day. There's almost like a curse on this house that no large alliances shall be formed. And if they do, they are destined to blow up. Now, otherwise, it was a fairly chill day. They had like a big set of Jenga they were putting together. They played charades earlier, some other kinds of games and stuff like that. But it does seem now that the push for Joseph to be the one to put up on the block was really just that, for him to be the one to take that spot as the pawn. And people in the house do see the trio of T-Core, Chemo, and Rubina as the top priority to break up this week. But they are keeping T-Core in the dark about this, and she is so close to both of them. Oh, how fun it will be for her to be on the other side of a blind side with all the ones that she's been a part of so far this season herself. And leading up to right now, all of these blind sides that she's done, her past HOH, where she lost one of her closest allies in Tucker, she might now lose her second closest allies in 2 weeks back to back, due to all the decisions that she has made. But I don't think she will take credit for it being bad decisions. I think she would just put her shit on everybody else, because in her mind, she has never flipped on anyone. We could check out here our allegiance chart for the day. Haven't really changed much since yesterday. Everything's kind of really the same. But I thought this might be a good time to kind of go over and break down all the different house guests, kind of where their positionings are in the house, what it's looking like for the potential vote this week. So let's start off right at the top. Chelsie, she is playing the best game in the house right now. She's really got a lot of great connections with almost everyone in there. She's got T-Core watching her back. Meanwhile, she is not watching T-Core's back at all. She's got Cam kind of in her pocket, but she is a little bit worried about the whole connection with MJ kind of going on. She's a little jealous of that situation, so that's something to kind of keep an eye on. She's got a great working relationship with Quinn as well. She's got bonds with Leah. She's got stuff going on with Chemo and Rubina, but she sees them as people that need to go for T-Core to kind of come closer to her. She's kind of got a little bit of a relationship with Angela, but nothing more than just kind of the little conversations she has here and there, kind of reeling her in with the idea of a potential girls alliance. But also, I just think she doesn't see Angela as a potential threat and would have other targets in mind before she would come for her. Meanwhile, just underneath her, you have people like T-Core, Cam, and Quinn. Again, I think Cam is really not doing a lot, right? He's never really talking that much game. But he's really found himself in a pretty good spot, right, with his connections with Chelsie. I think he's got the really good bonds with MJ and even Leah, so they're not going to be putting him up anytime soon. Same with Quinn. I think there's a lot of other targets in the house that would go before him, so he's in a pretty good spot. Quinn really doesn't have that many actual close allies that are fully investing in him. He's got people that are connected to him, kind of using him as protection, a la Chelsie and Cam. He's kind of got the working relationship with Leah, but she's very much playing her own game. We'll get to her in a bit, too. He had Joseph really tight kind of in his pocket, but Joseph's kind of a floater anyway, would go to where the power was. And now that he put him on the block, that's a strained relationship. He put Chemo and Rubina on the block, so that's a really strained relationship as well. Honestly, I probably should lower him down, but since that HOH power kind of props him up for the week, I'm going to kind of leave him where he is, but he's definitely in a really tough spot after this HOH, which has kind of been a theme that if you win HOH, you're going to end up leaving in a worse spot afterwards. T-Core, again, she's kind of in a really good spot too, where it seems like people just kind of want to work with her in general. She's even kind of got Quinn misted the same way that she's misted under Chelsie. She's definitely still got Chemo and Rubina. If they both happen to stay in the game this week, that would be really great for her. But it does seem like the house is now seeing she's a part of this trio, and that is something that really needs to be broken up. With Rubina and Chemo, they're kind of on a similar plane as well, where one of them probably needs to just go this week, and everybody in the house kind of sees that. With the potential votes on how that could all play out, it does seem like Leah is more inclined to keep Joseph, since Joseph wouldn't be somebody that would put her on the block. Since Leah saved Angela, Angela's kind of promised her vote be aligned with Leah's vote. So wherever Leah votes, that's two votes that you can really kind of count on, at least for this week. We'll see how long that lasts until Angela gets paranoid and turns on Leah. But that would be two votes to go against either Rubina or Chemo, depending on who it would go. It seems like Chelsie is kind of on board, as well as MJ, to get out. Probably I would say Chemo over Rubina, but after that conversation with Chelsie and MJ, it does seem like they see Rubina is kind of the one keeping T-Core and Chemo kind of in line and kind of making sure they're in a good spot in the game. They think if they get rid of her, they would just kind of fall apart. T-Core comes closer to them, and that can be how that works. I think Cam, who had multiple times even before this week mentioned that, yeah, if I ever won HOH, I'd probably put the three of them up, and that those three are a definite huge threat even before Tucker was voted out. He was bringing this up, so I think he would very much be on board with that as well. And I could see Joseph actually staying this week, even though everybody was kind of pushing him and talking about him as being the potential target. Again, I think that was all just to really be him to be the one as the pawn, not necessarily the one that needs to leave this week. And they see him as being someone that can be a target moving forward as well, as almost a kind of a shield. MJ, again, she seems like she's really kind of just a floating free agent for anyone to grab. She's in a spot where she's kind of got a good relationship with Chelsie, but with the whole jealousy of the stuff with going on with Cam, that's kind of a tense relationship that you got going on there. It seems like she's got a bit of a building relationship with Quinn now that he's kept her off the block, didn't put her up as a replacement nominee. It seems like he's building a little bit of trust with her. So maybe that is somebody that can eventually work with Quinn a little bit closer. Leah, she's got just all the boys wrapped around her finger, whether it's Quinn, Joseph, even Cam slightly. But he now is seemingly moving towards MJ. There was a moment where MJ was rubbing Cam's hair and rubbing Leah's back. So maybe there's a quadrilateral going on with Chelsie, Cam, MJ, and Leah at this point. Meanwhile, Quinn and Joseph are desperately fawning over her as well. And then you have Angela, who's peeking up. She was under the waterline, below sea level, you could say, for a little while there. But after getting the veto used on her, kind of a little bit of a stuff going on with the Girls Alliance and with her connection with Leah, seems like, you know, she's poked her head back up just a little bit, able to breathe over that waterline. But let me know what you guys are thinking in the comments down below about everything going on in the house. What do you think about the potential votes this week being against Rubina or Chemo? Should one of them still be on the block, even against Joseph? It does seem like that trio of T-Core, Rubina, and Chemo are the big threat in the house for everybody. Let me know what you guys think about how everything will play out. Do you actually think there will just go for Joseph anyway, or will they actually break up that trio? Let me know what you guys are thinking. Thank you guys all again so much for watching. If you are new here, hit that subscribe button. You like this video, hit that like button, hit that notification bell. You'll never miss a video. You'll never miss a stream. We have tonight's episode will be the veto. We'll see everything play out with Joseph being nominated and Leah using it to save Angela. So we'll see how that all played out on the episode. Thank you guys all again so much for watching. Check out the links to my description. Check out the links to my socials in the description. Pinned comment down below. Things like my Twitch, Discord, Twitter, Kick, all the good stuff. Check it all out. And I will see you next time.
Arguing?
Oh.
Okay.
WWE. Fighting.
Yeah.
Big Brother.
No.
Matt.
No.
You're calling someone out.
Wait.
Okay.
What's
the category? Person?
Real Housewives.
Sports. Oh. Cheerleader. Oh.
Wrestler.
Oh, angry coach.
Yes. Oh. Nice.